Hello everyone, I hope you all are healthy and safe at your home. I, Ms. Kunjan Daswani from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota, welcome you all to your e-learning classes of English text, and today we'll be doing a chapter of your Gulmohar reader, that is chapter 9, A Rare Species of Uncle. So this chapter, that is A Rare Species of Uncle, is all about a well-known ornithologist, Salim Ali. So the writer, that is Zai Whittaker, so she is telling his her own childhood experience with Salim Ali, who was her grandmother's brother. Okay, so let's start with this chapter. This text is taken from a biography of Salim Ali, a well-known Indian ornithologist, famously referred to as the Birdman of India. Here, Zai Whittaker tells us about her childhood experiences with Salim Mamu, who was her grandmother's brother. So, as I told you, that Salim, the Zai Whittaker's relationship with Salim Ali was that she calls Salim Ali as Salim Mamu, and who was Zai Whittaker's grandmother's brother. Okay, so here in this chapter we'll be seeing her childhood experience with Salim Mamu. Okay, so before that, you need to mark your first new word, that is ornithologist. This is your first new word. You need to mark your first new word over here, that is ornithologist. Okay, but before that, now you have to mark your first internal question also in this paragraph only. I'm writing over here your first internal question. Who is famously referred to as the Birdman of India. Birdman of India. Who is famously referred to as the Birdman of India? And the answer to this question is Salim Ali. This is the answer to your first internal question. Okay, now moving forward, you can see over here also that it is given Salim Ali, a well-known ornithologist famously referred to as the Birdman of India. So answer is Salim Ali, and this is your first new word, that is ornithologist. Okay, now moving forward. Salim Bhai was my mamu, my grandmother Kamo's brother. By the time I was born, he was living with Kamo and her husband Hassan, a nana and nani in Bandra, Bombay. My parents are both nature lovers, and my father, Zafar Fateh Ali, became interested in birds through Salim Mamu. My mother, Laik, wrote a book with Salim Mamu called Common Indian Birds. Quite often, when new bird watchers are out in the field, one or two of them look into my mother's book to identify a bird. So, now, Salim Bhai was my mamu. Who is saying this? Zai Whittaker, the writer of this chapter. Okay, so Salim Bhai was my mamu, who was her grandmother Kamo's brother. Okay, so by the time the writer was born, he was living with her nana and nani, that was Kamo and Hassan, okay, in Bandra, Bombay. Okay, now my parents are both, now my Zai Whittaker's parents, they are both nature lovers, they love nature a lot, okay, and my father, that is, whose father I am talking about? Zai Whittaker's father. So her father Zafar Fateh Ali became interested in birds through Salim Mamu. Now her mother, that was Laid, she had written a book with Salim Mamu called, and the name of the book was Common Indian Birds. So this is the name of the book, that is Common Indian Birds. Okay, quite often when new bird watchers are out in the field, when there are new bird watchers, who are bird watchers? People who watch birds in their natural environment and recognize different varieties of birds. Okay, so these are bird watchers. So bird watchers, whenever there are new bird watchers who are out in the field, so if they have to identify a bird, then they will look into the book written by her mother, that is Common Indian Birds. It is the name of the book. Now here only you have to mark your second internal question. What is your second internal question? Name the book written by Zai Whittaker's mother, and Salim Ali. So what was the name of the book? So name of the book was Common Indian Birds. Okay, so this is the answer for your second internal question, that is Common Indian Birds. And here also you can see the answer, that is given over here in this paragraph over here on page number 85 itself. Okay, now moving forward. My brother, sister and I grew up in a very nature friendly atmosphere. At dinner we often heard words like habitat and ecosystem. Many discussions about nature and the environment took place around a beautiful old dining table in Juhu Lane, Andheri. So here she is telling us that all her siblings had grown up in a very nature friendly atmosphere. What is nature friendly atmosphere? It's a situation where people appreciate, where people loves nature, okay, and mean no harm to it, okay. So when people love nature, that time it is what? It is nature friendly atmosphere. So they had grown up in a nature friendly atmosphere. At dinner we often heard words like habitat and ecosystem. So when they are all the family sitting at the dinner table, when they are having their dinner, so there are discussions being going on about the habitat or ecosystem. So at the dinner table they used to hear these kinds of words. That is habitat and ecosystem. So what is habitat? That is the the place where a particular type of animal or plant is normally found. So that is the habitat. And what is ecosystem? Ecosystem is what? The way in which living things in an area relate to each other and their surroundings. Okay, now many discussions were about nature and the environment took place around a beautiful old dining table. So as I told you, so there were so many discussions when all the family is sitting together, then they used to have the discussion about nature, about the habitat, about the environment. Okay, so these all discussions had been going on when they were sitting at the dinner table. Okay, so these words were very common audible, were very commonly audible to them when they were sitting together, when they were having any kind of discussions. As we know that they are what? They are nature lovers. Okay, so now moving forward. So those days I greatly envied my school friends because they could sleep as late as they liked on weekends. So those days were there when they were small, when they were children. So those days I greatly envied my school friends. I was very jealous. I was very jealous from my school friends because they could sleep as late as they could. As they liked on weekends, like they have Sundays and we have Saturdays and Sundays. On Saturdays and Sundays, you can sleep as much as you want, isn't it? So same, that was Zaya Whittaker, that they have to wake up early on weekends too. Okay, so before that, you have to mark your next new word, which is ecosystem. This is your second new word, and your third new word is discussions. Okay, first was ornithologist, second is ecosystem, and the third one is discussions. Now moving forward. We, on the other hand, were woken up at 5:30 a.m. to go bird watching at Borivali Park, which is now a national park. Sometimes Salim Mamu would come along too. He would drive his Willy's Jeep like a battle tank, honking and shouting at every person and car on the road. So now what happens was, as I told you, that Zaya Whittaker was very jealous from her school friends because they could sleep as late as they liked on weekends. But they have to wake up at 5:30 a.m. because they used to go for bird watching at Borivali Park, which is now we call as Borivali, it's a national park. We all know about it, isn't it? So now, sometimes Salim Mamu would come along too. Now, Salim Mamu would accompany them sometimes. Okay, so he would drive his Willys deep like a battle tank, honking and shouting at every person and car on the road. Now, he just honk on every person he could see on the road while he is driving his Willys jeep. Okay, now, his temper, which was never very sweet, was definitely at its worst on the road. As passengers, we learn to shut our eyes and hope for the best. So now what happens was, now his temper, his mood, the way someone feels at the particular time, that is what is temper. Okay, so his temper, which was never very sweet, according to Zaya Whittaker, he was never very sweet. Okay, and his temper was definitely at its worst whenever he is driving. Okay, so as passengers, we just learn to shut our eyes. We just learn to shut our eyes and hope for the best. Okay, so that's what they do whenever Salim Mamu was driving. okay, so because they can't shout at him, because they can't even say him anything, okay. So now moving forward, at Borivali we had favorite walking trails in the forest following pretty streams and waterfalls. I was not a great bird watcher and still remain so. I keep buying bird books and binoculars, hoping that these will magically make me clever. But Saleem Mamu definitely had some secret bird finding talent. Okay, now what happens is, at Borivali, whenever as we all know that on the weekends we used to go to Borivali National Park. So at Borivali we had favorite walking trails. They were having favorite walking paths over there. Okay, so that is paths that are followed for a particular purpose. Okay, now this is your next new word. Before that, this passengers is there. Passengers is your next new word, and after passengers there is trails. Okay, now so following pretty streams, now the path was there. There was a way that was their favorite walking way, because they could see what? They could see pretty streams and waterfalls over from that path. Okay, so they used to just walk from that path only. Okay, I was not a great bird watcher and still remain so. I was not that much talented bird watcher, okay, and I still remain so. I'm not that much good. Okay, so who is saying this? This is being said by Zai Whittaker herself. Okay, so I keep buying bird books and binoculars, hoping that these will magically make me clever. So she used to buy bird books, binoculars are there. Okay, so she used to buy these kind of things. So she just hoped that I will become clever and I could easily identify the birds. I can easily do bird watching. Okay, but Saleem Mamu, she's saying that, but Saleem Mamu definitely had some secret bird finding talent. He was just having the secret talent within himself for bird finding. Okay, so Saleem Mamu was definitely having some secret bird finding talent. Okay, before that you need to mark your next new word, that is binoculars. Okay, now moving forward, he could see what no one else saw, hear what no one else heard. He could walk more miles than others, much younger than he. Even when he was old, he would ride a camel or pony, walk for hours in the hot sun, and climb up a shaky ladder to peer into a bird's nest. Okay, so now Zai Whittaker is sharing us Saleem Mamu's talent. Okay, over here. So in this paragraph she is telling us that he could see what no one else could see. Okay, he was just having that, bolte na barik nazar hoti hai bahut, that was there with Saleem Mamu. Okay, so he could see what no one else saw, and he could hear the noise of the birds. He could hear the voice of the birds also, and what no one else could hear. Okay, he could walk more miles than others, much younger than he. Even the young people can't walk as much as Saleem Mamu could. Okay, so even when he was old, he would ride a camel or pony, walk for hours in the hot sun, and climb up a shaky ladder to peer into a bird's nest. So whenever Saleem Mamu has to look into a bird's nest, he used to look carefully, he used to observe the bird's nest, he would just climb that shaky ladder also. So so we can see that how energetic and how much he was keen for bird watching, isn't it? So as children, my sister and I often went to stay with our Nana and Nani. Our bedroom, the guest room, used to be directly above Saleem Mamu's apartment. Okay, so as children, my sister and I, that means Zai Whittaker and her sister, Okay, so they used to spend their holidays with their nana and nani. You also do that, isn't it? So, our bedroom, whenever that was the guest room, okay, at her nana nani's place. So, they used to stay there only, in that guest room only. So, it was just directly above Salim Mamu's apartment. Okay, so during our stays, we always hoped that Salim Mamu would be away in some jungle or mountain or desert. And he often was. We loved to play hide and seek with our cousins, and Salim Mamu did not like noise when he was working. But what is the fun of hide and seek if you can't yell and shriek? When he came up the steps to shout, "Keep quiet," we would all dive under the beds in fright. However, our nervous giggles would soon give us away. So, now whenever they were staying at their nana nani's place, so what happened was they just hoped that Salim Mamu was not there whenever they were staying at their nana nani's place. Okay, and quite often he wasn't there also. So as children you also love to play hide and seek. So same happened with Zaya Whittaker and her siblings and her cousins too. Okay, so they used to play hide and seek. And what is the fun of hide and seek whenever you are playing hide and seek? If you can't just shout, if you can't just yell, and if you can't just enjoy. Okay, so now same happened with them too. And Salim Mamu, now if he was there at their nana nani's place. So when he is working, he did not like noise at all. Okay, so whenever they are making noise, whenever they are enjoying, whenever they are yelling, whenever they are shouting or shrieking, so that time he came up the steps to shout them, "Keep quiet," he just said to them, and we would all dive under our beds. And what we do is we just jump into our beds in fear. Okay. How our nervous giggles would soon give us away. Now, to show someone or tell someone something that one wants to keep secret. Okay, they just not want to share this thing with Salim Mamu. So, they were just very nervous at that point of time when Salim Mamu came up to the steps to shout them. Okay, now moving further. But before that, you need to mark some new words. First is apartment over here on this page, on page number 87. Okay, apartment is there, and in this paragraph we are having our next new word, that is giggles. Okay, and here is shriek. Okay, so apartment, shriek, giggles. Now moving further, but we on the other hand had to put up with the noise of his typewriter at 5 in the morning. Clack, clack, clack. There were no silent computers then, and he typed most of his books himself. When I see his book of Indian birds, I still grumble to myself. It really robbed us of our sleep. Okay, so now what happens was, but we on the other hand had to put up with the noise whenever in the morning at 5. Salim Mamu's typewriter's clack 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 was going on. Okay, because as Salim Mamu used to write books on, he loved bird watching. He used to write books on birds only. Okay, so whenever he was typing his book, so at that time there were no silent computers. So whenever he was typing on his typewriter, the voice came very loudly, and this could disturb these small children. Okay.